and the God of the streets, you approach him, you have to understand that he's a God of the streets. For that reason, I am not actually here to express my love, to seek God, to serve God the way I will serve God in my own country. I am here to serve God because I want God to do something for me. So for that reason, you are approaching God with a wrong word, concept. And unfortunately, some of us, we don't even want to know it. That is the reason why this message is meant for you. To actually bring you to a place of reality check-up. A place where you have to begin to analyze, why am I seeking God in this man? Because there are many people that are supposed to be in the house of God today because they fail, because they fail that God has disappointed them, that God has not answered them based on certain things that they are seeking God to do for them. God is not doing it. Because of that, they fail that there is no reason for me to what? Go to church. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. So the question is, we are not just preaching for preaching's sake. The question is, ask yourself a rhetorical question. A question you ask yourself, you don't expect an answer, but you just receive the answer to yourself. Amen. First one, receive grace. Amen. So the question is why am I not serving God? Why am I going to night prayers? Why am I doing what I am doing for God? Why am I sacrificing, helping people the way that I'm helping them? Is it because I'm actually doing it out of sincere love for God? Or I am doing it for my selfish interests? Because I have found myself in such a place before. I can remember 2005, when I was in the valley of the shadows of death or sickness. I never believed in my life, though I was brought up in a Christian home. I was born and brought up in deeper life. My mother is a staunch, deeper life woman. Do you understand now? So I was born and brought up in deeper life. I grew up under the word of God. Amen. Please take care of prosper. Amen. Praise the Lord. So in all this while, I was following my mother to church. I was not actually a born again. I was just a church goer. Because I never really knew why I was going to church. I see church as a ceremonial gathering. I see church as a mandate, it's compulsion that you must go. If you don't go, you'll be what? Punished. I see that the God I am serving is like, is being imposed on me. I am forced to serve God. Until 2005, I never knew. I thought I was a Christian. I thought I was serving God. But I never knew that my interior motive of serving God, it was out from the concept. It was out of the parameter of love for God. I was serving God because I should not be what? Punished. Until 2005 came, when the enemy afflicted me, when the doctor failed, when everything that needs to be done has been done, and the failed, that I saw myself going down to the pit of hell. I saw myself in the jaws of death, and I told myself that now that I know I am going to die, now that I know nothing can be able to save me. I said, but I know they are preaching me that if you have nothing, if you have not done anything for God, if you die, God is going to what? Question you. What have you what done with your life? So for that reason, I decide. I said, okay, now I will start evangelism. You see my motive. I said I will start evangelism because I know my body system has changed. I know that there is nothing on earth that will make me to exceed the next week. So I begin to visit my relative with the concept that if I die tomorrow, they will say he was here yesterday or day before yesterday. Are you getting it now? Praise Master Jesus. So I decided that I know that God is the judge of the living and what and of the dead. And if I die, it's inevitable I must go to the seat of what? Judgment. Because it's appointed once unto a man to what? Die, after thou comes judgment. So I pick up the Bible. I don't know what to say. I don't know anything in the Bible. I pick up the Bible. And I started evangelizing in my house. And my brothers and sisters, I do not know why I take the decision, because I was a very shy type. That when it becomes 18 people is a crowd, I don't talk anymore. I can only talk when there is what? Me and what? You. Are you getting it now? But when I was afraid that if I die, what will I tell God? I said, okay, for this reason, I will decide to what? Start evangelism. I pick up a Bible. I started with my brothers and my what? Sister. With the concept, with the mind, that if I die, Jesus will see that I was what? Evangelizing on his name. You see, the driving force behind my action. Did you get it now? You see, my motive, there was an ulterior motive for my selfish gain, not because I know the souls I was reaching out for. I was doing it on the notion that I am going to do it in order to escape what? Judgment. I was doing it so that I can find favor for my personal what? Internal gain. That was the approach. That was my mindset. And I started evangelizing. I evangelized with my brothers and sisters. I entered the nearby house. From the next house to the next house. From the next house to the next house. From the next house. But I noticed one strange thing happened. That when I begin to evangelize, I see wolves that I know I am not in charge of coming out of my mouth. Because nobody has ever taught me how to what? Evangelize. The only scripture I can actually hold on to was John 3:16. For God so loved the world, and he said, so you must not perish. Come and know this Son of God, so that you might be what? Saved. That was how I go. Did you get it now? So I was doing these things for God because I was compared. It was not from what? True what? Love. That is what I wanted to get. Praise Mr. Jesus. I begin to evangelize. I enter the next house, from the next street to the next street, from the next street to the next street. Before you know, all horror and medical sorrow, I have evangelizing. Anybody in those areas, if they see me, they know that this is a man of what? God. And as I begin to evangelize, I begin to notice a strange thing in my life. Me that says that I will die in next week, in 2 months, I will see on evangelism. Every day, I pick up my Bible. So you see, my motive for doing it for God, if I had died at that moment, my work would have been what? In vain. I want you to get it, because you are going to somewhere. Because the word of God says that the world, every work we are doing, they are going to pass through what? Fire. And if you do it without a sincere love for God, your works are going to be what? Burnt. He said, but by grace, you yourself will be what? Saved. So now, why am I preaching this message to you? Are you just like me in those years? That I was doing what I was doing for God so that my own soul might be saved? Are you doing it for a selfish motives, for your personal gain? Are you coming to church because you are in the street, you need God intervention? I'm telling you today, if that is your motive, you are approaching God to the wrong direction. See, it's very important that we know whatever you are doing for God, it doesn't matter the amount of sacrifice you sacrifice in the name of God. God is not moved by it. God is moved with the intent of your heart. He's moved by your motive. If you are doing it for God, God will say, "Why is this person? Why is this person doing this thing for me?" He wants to know, because the Bible says something very interesting in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 3. He said, "Do not be arrogant. Do not speak proudly." He said, "Because God is a God of knowledge, who weighs your action." In other words, you are acting. You are doing things. You are coming to church. You are praying. You are fasting. God will say, "Why is this man fasting? Is he fasting this 7 days fasting because he loved me? Or is he fasting it for his own personal gain?" Please listen now, because this is the reason why many have prayed unanswered. It's very important to get it. Why are you fasting? You are fasting because nothing is working out. You want God to open doors for you. Is that all that God deserves from you? Why are you doing what you are doing? Why are you coming to church the way you are coming to church? Is it actually for your love for God? Because the church is the church of God. The church is not the church of man. The church is owned by God. He said, "On this rock I shall build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail." You see what the scripture says in the book of Daniel. See, everything we are seeking for in life is wrapped up in our love for God. Daniel chapter 9, verse 4. Verse 4. He said, "He is the great and the awesome God, who gives covenants and mercy with those that love him and obey his commandments." See, all we need in life is the covenant of God and the mercy support of God. All you will ever need in life, is it in money? Is it money you need? He said, "Remember the Lord that God, who has given you the power to make wealth, so that he may confirm the covenant that he has made with your father, as it is these days." Even in the wealth you are seeking for, you are going to receive it on the platform of what? Covenants. Because wealth does not come by hard labor. Because wealth does not come by what? Intelligence. He said the battle is not to the strong, neither the race to the swift, neither food for hard workers, neither riches for those with intelligence. You see a lot of intelligent, educated man broke because riches does not work, depends on it. When God sees the intent of your heart, please, 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 I beg of you, listen to this message carefully. Ask yourself this question, because it says, check yourself. Examine yourself whether you are seeing what in the faith. Examine yourself. Examine yourself. This is a message that will bring you to the valley of examining yourself. Why am I serving God? God does not want it. When you know God, you don't fast because you need God's intervention in your life. When you love God, you don't fast because You want God to destroy your enemies. When you know God, you don't fast and pray because you have the business at hand. And this is the reason why most of the time, everything flow, everything capsize, everything work erratically against you. The things are supposed to work perfectly. Because you can see God as a God of the streets. Praise the Lord. What is your love for God? Do you really love Him? He said, God is a great and an awesome God. He keeps covenant. See, when the God keeps His covenant with you, according to the book of Psalms, chapter 25, verse 14, He said, the secret of God is with those that fear Him, and He keeps His word, His covenant. The secret. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord for Jesus. Why are we serving God the way we are serving Him? It's very important to ask yourself, why have you made all those sacrifices? Are you making it because you are expecting return from God? What is your motion? What is your motive, baby? What is your intention? Because that is what God wants you to do. He searches your heart. God told me. It was not a sleep. I heard it as I'm talking to you. He said, if you can love them, whatever you need to help them will be what? If you can what? Love them. If you can love the people that I'm going to give to you, and then there was no church. He said, if you can love them, whatever you need to help them will be what? Given to you. What you need from God is accessible to you to love. And it's very important. The love for God. Why am I doing what I am doing? Why am I coming? Why did I come to church today? Is it because I came that I may feel good? Is it because I come just to fulfill more righteousness that I go to church? Because I bear a tag of called Christianity. Is that why you are coming to church? If that is the reason why you are coming to church, I tell you, there is no reward. But if you are coming to church with the motive, with the intention that I am coming because I love my Father, I am coming to worship Him, I am coming to reverence Him, I am coming because I need a word from my Father, because the word of the Father is what waters my souls. If that is your intention, I tell you today, you will never return the same way you came.
Amen.
Do you understand?
Yes.
Or if you are coming to church because I have a function in the church, because I have a responsibility in the church, if that is the reason why you are coming to church today, you have to repent. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You have to repent. The church of God is God Himself. The Bible says that the church is the body of Christ, the fullness of Him that filleth all in all. The church. Are you getting it now? Do you understand? Please get it right. Ask yourself this question. Love God with all your heart. Without no strings attached to it. I serve God in years without one rupee. So my love for God was not driven, it was not compared because what I expected God to give to me, if I have followed God because of what God can give, I will never be a pastor today. Because I encounter God in the wilderness where there is no life. I sacrificed years seeking God. If I have been following God because of money, I will not be standing before you today. Because I know I was doing what I was doing because I love God. Even when I was serving under another pastor, I never see anything. I never see it that I was serving a man. I saw it that I was serving God. Most of you that is here now, you can bear me the testimony today. You are a witness of this testimony. I was serving God because the love of God was burning in my heart. I begin to fast because I want to know more of Him. Not because of what He can give to me. Because I was not expecting God to give me any money. All I was seeking God is, God, I want to know more of You. God, I need a fresh revelation. God, give me the ability to walk in the leading of Your Spirit. Give me the grace. That was my motivation of fasting. God saw it and said, yes, that is what God is looking for. Do you understand now? God wants us to approach Him with the heart of love, not with the intention of what God can what give. That was the secret of Moses. The Bible says that the children of Israel, they will know the acts of God, but Moses knew His way. Moses did not know God because he wanted God to part the Red Sea for them. Moses did not approach God because he wanted God to demonstrate miracle through him. He was sold out for God. His love was after God. His heart was after God. And because of that, God said, yes, you are qualified to bodily carry the presence of my glory. Because of that, praise Master Jesus. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
See, I want to correct one error that the Spirit of God has placed in my heart. There was a church, I was an assistant pastor before, a diplomatic church in Delhi, for the faith. I met one of the members that was attending that church. That we were attending the church together. So I asked him, how is the church now? I hope you are still going to that church. He said, no, I am not going to that church again. I said, what happened? So he told me something that compelled me to educate him on this ministry that I'm about to say. He told me something. That in that church, that he did not go to church for 2 Sundays. Nobody called him. For that reason, he stopped. He said, if there is anybody that paid tithe, he paid tithe more than all the diplomats in that church. He said, I have helped, I have contributed financially to that church. He said, I am not boasting, but I am just saying that. At least they're supposed to what? Ask after me. I just read the level of what? Of his understanding. I just know where he's coming from. Amen.
Amen.
So he was naturally going to that church because of what man could do for him. He was not going to that church. He does not go to that church because he was serving God, because he loved God. He did not see that church as a church of God. He sees it as a church of man. And his tithe that he said he was giving, he did not see himself giving it to God. He see himself, he was helping out, he was helping the church out of financial what? Predicament. For that reason, a little thing happened. He got angry that if I am contributing immensely financially to the church, they're supposed to take me what? They're supposed to honor Amen. You see it now. And that brings me to let you understand some certain things. If you are coming to this church because of your contribution in one way or the other, and you thought you are helping me, you are getting it wrong. You are not paying your tithe to man. And Jesus said in the book of Luke, when the woman came and brought and cast the leaf of the money, all the money she had, she cast it into the offering box. And Jesus was watching. And the Bible says, all the rich men came out and gave abundantly. And Jesus Christ said, and remember, Jesus was not the presiding priest in that synagogue. It was the Pharisees. And the Pharisees, they have missed God already. Because they have rejected Jesus, their Savior. But see, Jesus was in the synagogue. Jesus said, he said, look, all these people that have given, they gave out of the abundance in their what? In their pocket. He said, but this woman gave all she had. He said, I tell you, she has given all she had to God, not to the Pharisees, not to the temple. Are you getting it now? I want you to change your conception. She gave it to God. She is giving it, not compared, but she is giving it out of love. And God said, Jesus said, he said, I bear you witness that this woman has received what? A greatest what? Reward. Because the rest of them, they were coming to give out of their abundance. They were not giving out of their heart, out of the love they have for God. They were not giving to honor God. They were giving out of their abundance. Just it's a normal word routine. Let me just what give. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I want you to know. See, there is something I want to say now. Please listen attentively. It's very important. Many people have been tithing with the concept of buying and trading. If you are tithing with the concept of you expecting God, because I get my tithe, God will now visit me next week. You are approaching God with the wrong word concept. You are not going to get it. In other words, you are not paying because it came out of your heart. You are paying because of what you expect God to what give to you. God is not a trader. See, until you understand the method of the tithing of Abraham to Melchizedek, Abraham was not tithing under the law. Abraham tithed to honor God. Abraham was not asked to tithe. According to the book of Genesis chapter 14, if you read from verse 18, Abraham did not tithe to God because there was a law that says in Malachi 3, verse 10. No, he was not driven by law. And until you understand that concept, if you are driven by law to pay tithe, your tithe never shall increase. But if you are driven by law and you are bringing it to honor what? God and not to man, then you see your heavens will be open. Do you understand now? I'm just giving you a key. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. Praise Master Jesus. Because God is not a man that he should lie, neither a son of man that he should change his mind. If he has said it, he will do it. If he has promised it, he will make good his promises. What is it that we are paying tithe, we are not getting the return? Because we are bringing it with the wrong word, motive. God is not a buyer. God is not a trader. Do you understand now? God is not a trader. So if you are bringing your tithe with the mindset that God, I am bringing it, so in this week, I'm expecting what? Abundance is wrong. I must tell you the truth. Do you understand now? Or if you are bringing it because you are afraid that if I don't bring my tithe, God is going to shut up my heaven. You have missed it. Do you understand now? It's not out of what? Love. Do you understand? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Is it getting through?
Yeah.
If you are doing it because you are afraid that if I don't pay my tithe, God is going to destroy my finances. He's going to shut every door through which all the doors of financial deregulation, all the financial strains, is going to block them. If that is the notion why you are paying your tithe, you are wrong. From today, go repent. Ask God for forgiveness. When you want to pay your tithe, see it that you are using it to what? Honor what? God.
Amen.
You are bringing it in honor to God. You are bringing it to appreciate God. Are you getting down? You are not prepared. You are not driven by fear. By bringing it to God. Praise Master Jesus. We are under grace now. Let it come out of your heart. Do it with joy. Graciously. Do you understand? Then you see the blessings of God. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
See our love for God. The love for God. Are we praying to God the way we are praying? Because we are afraid not to get into trouble. Because we don't want God to deliver us. We want God to protect us. Is that the reason why you are praying? Is that the reason why you are praying in the midnight? Is that the reason why? If that is the reason of your prayers, you are praying a wrong word, prayer. You are approaching the throne of grace with selfish interest. The Bible says in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 16, verse 9, it says something so very powerful. It said, the eyes of the Lord, he walked up and fro over the earth to show himself strong on behalf of those that perfectly set their heart upon him. Did you see it now? Do you understand?
Yes.
In other words, those that love him from their heart, those that are doing what they are doing because they love him. He said the eyes of God is moving on the earth to and fro to show himself strong on behalf of those that perfectly set their heart on him. See, God searches your heart in every action you take, in everything you do. He searches your heart to know the intent. It is the intent, the motive behind that thing you are doing that will determine the intervention, the hand of God in your life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
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 Do you understand now? See, when the eyes of God is upon you, there is no evil eye that can bring you down.
Amen.
When the eyes of God is upon you, no devil will dare come near you because you are in the glory, in the presence of God. So what will make these eyes of God to be upon you when you give your heart toward to God? It's unfortunately that some of us, we have given our heart to material things that will lose the visions of God. We lose the visions of the true love for God. We are approaching God, going to church today because we want God to have mercy on us. No, or you want God to protect you. You want God to preserve you in this land so that you will not have any problem. See, I'm giving you a key. I'm giving you a principle. Are you getting it now? He said the eyes of the Lord is upon those. He's walking to and fro upon the earth to show himself strong on behalf. In other words, you don't even know it. God will begin to fight your battle because you have perfectly set your heart on him. Did you get it?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Amen.
If your heart is rightly set on God in everything, see, God will be your protector in business.
Amen.
Any man that will dare to eat your money, he will find himself in what? In trouble. Do you understand that? Because he said, I am the God that bless the works of your hands. Why? Because what? You love him. So for that reason, you are qualified for his word, his blessings. anything that will come against, any default, any cacao or caterpillar that will rise financially against your finances, God will destroy them. Because He is your blessings. Praise the Lord. Praise be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Is your heart set on God? Is your heart perfectly, according to that scripture in the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 16 verse 9, is it perfectly set on God? That, oh God, for you I live. Oh God, for you I live. If I die, I die for you. If I live, I live for you. In what? In riches, in everything that I want for you. There are many people that are supposed to come to church today. Some they do not come. They don't feel like coming. Because they look at themselves, they look at the situation. Why is my situation not still what changed? Why has God not done something about it? For that reason, they are not prepared. They are not willing to go to church because they fear that God has what disappointed them. And that is not the mind that God wants us to what approach. Praise be to Jesus. The love for God from your heart. Love God with all your heart. Everything you need will be given to you. Just as He told me, He said, if you can love them, whatever you need to help them will be what? Given to you. Lastly, when we are talking about God, don't see beyond this church. Don't see beyond the roof and say, God in heaven, the love you have for your brothers. Whenever you express your love for your brother, you are expressing the love of God in your heart. If you love God, it's very easy to love God. If you tell me to love God, and look at your relationship within your what? Your brothers. What relationship do you have with Him? Because the Bible says in the book of 1 John chapter 4, it says you cannot love, you cannot say to love God and hate your brother that you want, you see. He said this is the commandment we receive from Him, that he that love God also love His brother. But look at especially the blacks in the land of India today. There is no love. There is no love. You cannot love me and be jealous of me when God is blessing me. I went ahead and give my contact to policeman to track me down. Is that love?
No.
You cannot love me and sit on my money. You cannot love me. I do business with you. You kill my money. Is that love?
No.
Love protects. Love cares. Love puts you in the shoe. If I was on the shoe, how would I want feel? Do you understand? It's not just all about coming to church. What is your relationship with your brothers and sisters? If you are fasting and praying, doing everything, can approach the swinging in tongues of angels and in tongues of men and in tongues of fire. The Bible says if you have no love in your heart, you are like a thing, an empty cow that is what? Making noise. Do you understand that? This is very important. You are praying in church, doing everything, but you hate your brother that is sitting in the other end, in the same church. And yet, you confess you love God. Is that love?
No.
Is that love?
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. It's time we begin to ask ourselves, how much do I actually love this God? Because your love for God is determined by your love for your brothers and sisters. Praise the Lord. It's determined by the love of your brothers and sisters. How will you love your brother so much that when God bless him, you become his enemy? When God bless him, you begin to gossip him. When God bless him, everything about you against him is changed. You are angry for no reasons. Jesus Christ said, In the book of Matthew chapter 5, it's, I think from verse 21, he said, you have heard, it was said in the Old Testament, that whosoever that more than anybody will face one judgment. He said, because, he said, for now I tell you, if you hate your brother without a cause, you are going to face what? Judgment. If you hate your brother without a cause, you are planning evil against your brother because God is blessing him. See, if you want to be blessed, associate with those that God has what? Blessed. The blessing will transfer unto you. Do you understand?
Yes.
Because most of the time, blessing is contagious. Blessing has an atmosphere. The Bible says something in the book of, I think, 2 Samuel chapter 6. He says something that when the presence of God was in the house of Obed-Edom, anybody that wanted to be blessed, he came to the time that anybody that visited Obed-Edom, God would bless them. Do you understand? And the report came to meet the king and said that God has blessed Obed-Edom to the extent that anybody that visits Obed-Edom, they are even receiving what? Blessing. Blessing by association. Did you get it now? Did you get it now? Amen. Do you understand? Instead of you to be angry and to be jealous, God knows for him. That grace on him will transfer to you. Do you understand now?
Yes.
It will transfer to you because it is certain. The Bible says in the book of Genesis chapter 13 verse 5 that even Lot also that followed Abraham, because Abraham was blessed, even Lot also that followed Abraham had many cattle and many what? Sheep. He has many tents. He has many houses. What make Lot to be blessed? Because he make a company with them. Blessed. He became what? Blessed. Do you understand? Do you understand now?
Yes.
Please get it right. Have a pure heart. Have a pure heart towards one another. Love your brothers and your sister the way what? You love yourself. Don't hurt anybody because God is blessing your person. Because when God begins to bless you, you see some friend that you were together before, all of a sudden they say that you are becoming what? Pompous. And for your own good, when God begins to bless you, don't raise your shoulder. Still be a friend of those you have been a friend to. Still talk to them in the way you used to talk to them before. Because that was what Paul taught Timothy in the book of 2 Timothy. He said, rebuke those that are rich. Take them to lay up treasures in heaven. Take them to be free to communicate. Because some, when God bless them, actually some people, it gets into their what? Into their head. They will not talk again. You are talking to them now, they want to tell you that I am no longer your what? Your mate.
Hey.
You understand? And the Bible says that pride goes before what? Destruction. When something's happening, the person is what? Is in danger. He becomes a demon to his success. Because any proud man does not need any more demon. He's already a demon to his grace. Because the Bible says that God gives grace to the humble and resists what? The proud. Praise Master Jesus. So when God is blessing you, don't let the blessing get into your head. Still see yourself in the rain. Don't exalt yourself above what you are not. Do you understand now? The blessings of God, it does not come with pride. Do not allow pride to get in. When pride gets in, that means the devil is ready to destroy that blessing. Be free. That was what Paul told Timothy. He said he shouted to be free to what? Communicate. And to give to the poor. He shouted so that they will lay up treasures what? In
heaven.
Praise Master Jesus.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I believe you have received the word of God today.
Yes.
It's very important. Humble yourself.